All right, round number three. Let's see what happens. That's probably a mulligan. I'll keep this one. Whoa, hello. And yes, absolutely. That's a perfect card to put on top. That gives us access to this and this. The Cruel Ultimatum is kind of a mulligan, you know, here, but we could definitely cast it later on if we're in a slow matchup. And hitting our land drops going forward is a pretty big game. Sylvan Ranger. Let's have a Sylvan Ranger fight, I guess. Nice. I kind of just wanted to hit a land there, I think. By the way, this is a great draw. This means we actually might be able to cast a Cruel Ultimatum at some point here. Should I just leave a rewind, actually, and teachings? Probably. My opponent could cast some pretty nasty stuff this turn. And yeah, we'll take some hits from Sprouting Thrinax, but whatever. It is just a 3-3 for 3, which is a nice threat, but nothing insane. Like, they could easily cast Falconwrath Noble here, for example, which would be super, super annoying. It's going to take this. Sure. I'm going to go get a mountain here because this gives us two red. Get teachings. I don't even know what I'm going to get. I got infinite stuff. Untap land would give me Mystic Genesis, but I won't have that. Soul Manipulation is medium here. Actually, I can't even cast it yet until I get the Crumbler down, so that's not great. Opportunity is definitely a card I should look into. In fact, I think I'm just going to take that. Because, yes, I can't cast it yet, but I will be able to soon. And I can cast it next turn, in fact, so I'm just going to pass here. Ooh, you got something? Magma Jet and me. Wow. Going upstairs. Top bottom. Take my medicine. I'm countering whatever this is. Ooh, that's a good draw. That's a really good draw. So let's see, we've got blue, blue, red, red. It's not a really great draw. We're still not gonna be able to actually cast it. I'm just gonna pass. I can opportunity or flashback teachings. We're still setting up for Cruel at some point though. Oh, there's that Falconwrath Noble I didn't want to see. Now they're going to attack with a Sylvan Ranger, too. I'm going to go ahead and block here. Yikes! Am I dead? Not quite. Pretty close. red, black, 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 blue, blue. I think I can just crawl here. Black, blue, blue, red. So they sack this, they get a whole bunch of little dudes. I go up to 8, they attack me for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 after the sack, I'm at 1. But I wipe out their hand. Let's see if I have any other options. 2, 3, 6. I could have 1 mana up from after teachings. That doesn't do anything. All right. Oh, wait. Did I miscount anyway? Black, black. Yeah, I did. I miscounted anyway. All right. Ugh. So we're pretty dead then. If I go for Urban Evolution, what can I even hit? Wow, I'm in a bad spot. This card is so nasty against us. If I play Sylvan Ranger, I can chump block here and then die. If I pass with these up, then they just attack me and I die. So none of these work. I can't cast Cruel because I need another black mana source. So I have to cast Urban Evolution. And pray for something. I figured Agony Warp would be part of the equation here. Shrink, kill. I take 2, I go to 1. That actually works. Agony Warp indeed, my friend. Agony Warp indeed. So I go to 1. Dead to anything. Just don't kill me. Don't. What? Oh, that's fine. Oh, man. Are we going to come back here? It's possible. It's not impossible. So I can Cruel here. That wipes out their hand. They do still just get rid of the Thrynax, which leaves them with quite a board. Again, I go up to 6, and then I'm still just taking infinite. So I can't really do that. I can Soul Ransom the Thrynax. 1, 2, 3, 4. And leave myself 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 mana left over. For like Grizzly Spectacle on this Slave Driver. But then this Ranger kills me. Could I play Sylvan Ranger and Cruel Ultimatum? Let's see, this, and then I can go black, 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 red, red, blue, blue. So yes, I can do that. And then where does that leave me? They sack the Sprouting Thrynax. I go up to 6. I can chump block here, and I take 1, 2, 3, 4. And they have no cards. We draw cards. I get back Coiling Oracle. Sure, whatever. It doesn't even matter. I can also just Soul Ransom. If I Soul Ransom the Sprouting or the Grixis Slave Driver, it comes back over here. They draw their card. They pitch both to send it back. Then they attack me with both. Or they just attack me with both. I block this, I kill this, or whichever way I want to do it. That works too, actually. Because if they go for it, if they just pitch both cards and just say, okay, get that thing out of the way, attack with both, then what happens? Ooh, that's one thing I can do. Hold on a second. 1, 2, 3, 4. Steal the Thrynax and then Grizzly it. I can Grizzly Spectacle it and get 3/1/1 chump blockers. And then that sets up Cruel Ultimatum for the next turn. That's kind of sweet. I actually don't know what the best option is here, though. I like that. I like that as an option. Or I can just take the Grixis Slave Driver and pass. If they attack with both, I block the Slave Driver on the Thrynax. I kill this with the Grizzly Spectacle. I don't take any damage. Then I untap and I Cruel. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. I have already played a land, so I can't play Sylvan Ranger into both of those things, because that would actually be really good too. All right, I'm going to go for this play. This guy's got the reads. Okay, so do I need to just do this right now? I think I just do, because if I pass the turn, they go up to 2 cards, and if I go tap, 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 kill this, then they go pitch, pitch, get it back, and then this resolves, and then they get the things, which of course kills me. So let's do this. Still have to dodge here, though. What? No trade? I think they sensed the Cruel. I mean, he called it in the chat. I think they thought I was going to cast it right there, but they want to be able to sack the Sylvan Ranger to it, I believe. All right, let's do this. Thank you. Now I will Cruel Ultimatum you. This guy, he's got my number, knows what I'm up to. Okay, and I milled a Zealous Conscripts in there too. I think I probably just want Coiling Oracle though, which I can cast now. They had 2 lands in hand. Sure. I don't need more cards. Now I just need to be able to untap without being dead. And I think that's pretty likely. 6 life's a lot to get through here in just one attack step. Whoa! Harmonize off the top. Holy smokes. Well, at least I've got 2 hard counters in hand. Seal of Doom's not doing me any favors. Not at the moment. All right, so how much mana do I have? 3, 7, 8, 9. I've got 10. So I can cast like this and this. That seems fine. I'm just going to pass here. I'm just going to rewind because it keeps me all my options open. The same options I had before, that is. Sure. A little bit of a risk here I'm taking. Let my opponent attack. Then I'm going to play Spire Monitor. Then I'm going to double block. And then I'm just going to Mist Raven it. I played this first in case they wanted to attack and then kill one of my blockers. So they're going to get a 2-2 out of the deal, which is mildly annoying, but still better than having to face down Madcap Skills guy. Let's pass here. And I will... Got another Magma Jet? What in the world? All right, I go to 4. I want to counter the 6 drop on the way back down with Mystic Genesis. I don't think I have any more to get. Oh, of course I do. Let's see here. So I can get Soul Manipulation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can get Soul Manipulation or a Spire Monitor. I'm talking about with Mystical Teaching. So I can counter some stuff, but I can't counter everything. I could just play Seal of Doom, but I don't think it's worth it here because the Soul Manipulation kind of gets that job done anyway. And I've got Lethal here and here. They're going to be able to flash back this guy. Oh, no. No! Anything but that! Yeah, all my hard counters are gone. And I can't do anything about it. Well done. That was a sweet game. No doubt about it. I feel like Basilisk Caller is good again. It's not great, but like my opponent is playing a bunch of ground dorks. I think I want possibly Cowrin Fear, probably 9 Zombie. I think I'm going to go for the slower version. Again, it does seem to be working better against these creature decks. We just don't see these that often. Oh, such a close one. Okay, so we get to play that on turn two, then maybe soul manipulation something the next turn. Okay. Well, game plan acquired, I guess. Taste it. And pass a turn back. I'll counter any creature, basically. Ooh, nice draw. Now we're kind of in business. That's actually awesome. That just made our soul manipulation way better, like maybe a 3-for-1. Top, that's not great news, but having rewind and soul manipulation is pretty good here. Any creature, I'm going to soul manipulation, that's for sure. Urban Evolution probably needs to wait, yes. Leaving up Spire Monitor and Rewind is just too good. I will rewind this. That's a lot of mana to use in one turn. Now I'm going to Urban Evolution. And be in pretty good shape. Thragdad. Man, that ain't bad, is it? I want one. I like that better. Another Falconwrath Noble, a Thunderous Wrath, Dragon Fodder, and Aristocrat. I'm just going to take the Noble here, I think. Sure. He's in there. Mm-hmm. And fodder as well. Oh, Burning Tree into fodder? Goodness sakes, you're going off. Ooh. That's kind of nice. Do I just put it on the Thrag? No, because it's never actually getting through, so I'll put it on this. Mm-hmm. Oops, I actually did not mean to click through that. I was just going to cast Mistraven, but fair enough. If I wasn't, it's funny. I wonder what my opponent thinks I have now. Cause like I would have moved a thing over or something. Don't think they can 20 me from here, right? I might be wrong. I'm not going to take any chances here. So let's see, it's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 13, 14, 15. No, it's still just not enough. So I'll just block this thing. And then I get to hit again with this. This time I didn't want to move the thing though. I'm just going to cast teachings. Mm-hmm. Don't think you have any attacks here though. Hmm. It's an easy trade for me. What do I want? Do I want a removal spell like Agony Warp? Or do I just want to get a rewind so I don't die to something weird? I think I just want Agony Warp. Pass priority. I think I'll do it like this. This ensures a trade here and makes sure that the Falconwrath Noble is off the battlefield one way or the other. Well, I shouldn't say it ensures a trade. They could sack their entire board to keep this guy alive, but I can't see that being a winning strategy for our opponent anyway. Because we're going to 9 here. Or, 13 here. And we still have a blocker. All right, easy game, easy game. I think these Dragscape zombies trading off for random 2/2s is actually pretty decent. Seal of Doom is medium. It doesn't hit the cards we really want to. So I think I'll just cut it. Cards we care about are like Falconwrath Noble. That's a big game. It's a really big one. The card we most want to counter, I think. Mm-hmm. Nothing? How's that possible? I'm not going to question it. I'm just going to be happy about it. Man, Urban Evolution is going to be good in a couple of turns. Still, I'm just going to take the Agony Warp. It's a one-shot answer for some of the problems we really care about. All right, you have your patented Magma Jet. I always forget. Bottom, bottom. Digging for a certain land type, perhaps. Core Clan. Such a weird card, Soul Ransom. They may just ditch to get it back, but if they do, yeah, I'm pretty happy about this transaction. Yes, I have to discard a card here, which is mildly annoying, but puts me in such a good position. I get to Grizzly Spectacle this, or Mist Raven it, or whatever, and then I just have like rewinds and opportunities for days. So I'm trying to decide if I want to get rid of a land here or just maybe one of the rewinds. Actually, an interesting decision. The Mist Raven's also not particularly important here, though it's not bad. All right, I'll be a little greedy here. I can still cast all my spells. Taking the hit here. Okay, pass. This isn't bad. I got the block here, and then I can just kill the Gore Clan Rampager with Grizzly Spectacle. And leave up Rewind. It's going to pass. We're in a pretty safe position from here, I think. Chandra's Outrage. Yeah, I'll rewind that. It saves us 2 damage and keeps our blocker up for Vampire Aristocrat, and it is fairly free for us at this point, I think. The Thragfather. Pretty annoying. So we'll counter it. Reload. Whoa! It's a lot of lands. Ooh, and then the last one was a good one. 2, 1, 2, 3. I guess I can just cast. This. And this pass. Snapping this off easily. Now we're going to start rumbling. Get rid of this for a turn. And start really trying to turn the tides on our opponent here. Go ahead. Resolves. Get rid of him. Just trying to slam the door on him here, obviously. How dare you? Sure, whatever. Still a 2-turn clock. sure. We're jamming. You're not dead yet. I need another mana to be able to kill them that turn, but realistically, they're dead. All right. Those are fun games. Man, that was a fun one to play. All of these ones were fun. Even the one we lost was super close and interesting games. Really, you can't ask for much more than that. And that is one of the things that this format has brought, is these control map mirrors are pretty sweet. And you end up with a lot of really close, really interesting games, and I think those ones were definitely that. That was fun. I would just keep drafting that over and over again, forever, I think. That is going to do it for this one. If you want to find me on social media, I'm Marshall_LR, and everything's related to the podcast at LRcast.com. See you next time. Thanks for hanging out.